Hello, dear viewers. Welcome to Giono's Daily Series, where we see how fast can we make something cool in Geometry Nodes. This is the second part of a three-part series dealing with reconstruction of this project that you see here. You will get the link for the first part in the description. You also see in the top right corner the link for the shading video. In this video, we are going to do the geometry. You also can download this entire project from Gumroad for only €2 and do whatever you like with it and support this channel in the process. The points that we are going to tackle today are in this card on the screen. Last time we did this part, we created these handles that we see here, and now it's time to move on and do other parts. So let's do a mesh. You can add anything you want. I'm gonna go to edit mode and do X, delete vertices, and this is going to be our setup. Let's say clock body. Excellent. So we will add a new geometry nodes tree and move it like here. I can delete this input, I don't care about it. I'm gonna do a frame and choose a color to make it everything inside it a lot easier to see. I'm gonna close this window here, and now we can start with the first point, adding the inner and outer dials. So for this, I'm gonna start. Let me close this. We don't need the controllers, and this is going to be in the clones collection. I will start by adding a circle. So let's do this curve circle, because I want to avoid as much as possible using the solidify modifier and the bevel modifier. We are not exactly working very nice. So I'm gonna do this circle, and I'm gonna decrease its radius a little bit. Let's do like 0.39, something like this. The points, I'm gonna increase the points, and then I want to turn this into a mesh right away. So let's do curve to mesh, and duplicate this circle, but reduce the number of the points. So let's do it like default and plug it here. And now we can play with the value. I know I need something small, not that small. Something like this. This is going to be the inner part of our geometry. And I want to do a little bit of stuff to this one. So I want to distort it a little bit. So let me add a geometry, set position, plug it here. And I want to do like two distortions. So I'm gonna do an input position. Let me get some more room here. And so then I'm gonna make like a vector multiply, take this position, plug it here into the position. Switch this on to multiplication, and now we can play a little bit with the values. So let me put one, and I'm gonna see the cavity. Where are you, cavity? I think it's here. Yeah, okay, so we can see things a little bit better. Let me play a little bit with these values, and I want to flatten basically this one out, but I don't want to flatten it uniformly. I just want to flatten the bottom and leave the top part intact. And the way to do this is by adding a mask. And the way I'm gonna use the mask is starting with the spline parameter. That's going to give us a factor from 0 to 1 on the length of this spline. So let me do a compare. Float is just fine. Plug this one here, and this will be plugged into this selection. And immediately we see something happening. And if I switch this one, leave it at 0, because I care about the 0 point, and then just play a little bit with this value, something like this. I'm getting a very nice shape, as you can see, that it's kind of flat on the bottom. It has a nice little lip and also roundness on top. And that's done by this playing with these values here. This is the lip and this is the flatness. So very nice. This is awesome. Alt-P, just put this one here, add a geometry, join geometry, and then we can switch to doing the second part. So let's duplicate this entire setup, Shift-D, and plug it here. Excellent. Now everything is on top of each other, but we will fix this in just a moment. Let's look at this value. Let's make it bigger. This will control how big the dial will be. So let's do something like, maybe something like this. And the profile, I want it also to be thicker. Maybe something like this. And I don't want to have the same profile. I want to change this. So let's see. Moving to this mask and to this node. So let's see. I want this to be a little bit more like donut-y shape. So let's do something like this. But I also want to have a little bit of interest and details, not have something flat. So I'm gonna play with these values a little bit. Something like this. And I also want to make sure that I change a little bit the profile, move it around. So let's move it. If I do something like this, I get this lip moving around, and I also can increase the factor of this one. Check out what's happening here. Now we are pushing this here. So now we get this nice lip here, this edge. Awesome. This is what I want to see. And it's looking pretty nice so far. We will also want to have a control for both of these to be able to decide if we have to move things later on. So let's do a transform for this one and also a transform for this one and plug it into the frame. Great. Now it's time to build the second part, the digit divider. I want to have some dividers here to go to have a nice frame kind of for the digits. And I don't want to keep the shape simple. I want to also want to have something that goes a little bit like this. And it's kind of flat in the bottom, but rounded on the top. So to make it like look a little bit antique, you know, hammered and stuff like that. So how to do this? Let me save this file first. Obviously, we will have to use a circle to make things happen. So let me take this curve circle and also the frame. So let's do Shift-D for this frame, Alt-P for this one, G, and now we have this one nice here. And this will be the reference for what we are going to do here. Let me make it. Let's do 0.5 for this one, so we can see it. We will adjust things later on if it's needed. And we want to divide the to instance the divider on this one. So we kind of need to have 12 because we will need 12 dividers. Great. And like I said, we need to instance something on this point. So let's do that. Let's do an instance. And we will instance and sculpt a cylinder. So we'll start with this nice geometry cylinder. Plug this one here and plug it into the instance. And a bunch of things are happening here. First of all, this is looking kind of big. So let's make it like, I don't know, 0.5. And I'm gonna use like a little bit of thickness, and I'm gonna need the resolution because this is going to be sculpted a little bit. So now we have this thing. We will need a transform for this one. So geometry transform to align it to the correct axis. And the correct axis is rotated around the Y, something like this. It's gonna be great. And of course it's still too big, so let's decrease the instance's size. And now we get something. Let me add also quickly a set shade smooth, plug it here. Excellent. And it's looking, everything is looking great. Let's get some bit of space. First of all, things are not exactly aligned correctly, so let's fix that. Let's, and I just remember, I kind of have to activate the screencast keys. Or I had it activated, I don't remember. So let's do in utilities, align Euler to vector, plug it into the rotation, and let's think about it, how we want to align this. We want to like use the y-axis as an alignment because we rotate it here. And I also want to use, by the way, if you find this confusing, just play around with the values and you'll get, I get confused all the time with this stuff. So let's align it to the curve tangent. Tangent, it's going like this on the curve. And that's what we want as a vector for alignment. And immediately we see things aligning nicely to our stuff. But first of all, I don't want this. I want this to be pushed in this direction, like 45 degrees, so that I can put the digit in between and start exactly here. And for this, let's take this node and plug it here. And I'm gonna do a minus 45 degrees for this one, and of course cancel this one, and now things are aligned perfectly because we rotate it around the z-axis, the one that you don't see here in the orthographic view. Excellent. So I did this. Now I want to do the flattening of this bottom part of this instance. So let's do that. Geometry, set position, plug this one here, and let's do this thing again. Control, we are going to need also this node. So Control C, Control V to escape the frame. Okay, and plug this one here into the position. Into the position, yes, in the position I wanted. And we want to flatten on one of the axes. So let's make this one on and see which one is the flatten. This is kind of what we want to figure it out. So this, let's make like 0.8 something and 0.1 maybe. Not on this axis. If you get confused, you can just, let's say, plug this one after as a last transform. So now we know exactly what axes are. We know that this is now our axes. Or you can play with them as much as you want. Anyway, now I want to select the bottom part. So let me use this position and do a separate on this one, because I want to be focused on only one axis, the one that is the flattening one, the X in this case, as we look at these graphics. Like I said, easy to get confused, but don't worry about that, because it's easy to just play with values. That's the beauty of proceduralism. So I want to check if things are greater than zero. And that was going to be my mask for this set position. So plugging it here, and you immediately see that the bottom is flattened out. Very nice indeed. And we also played a little bit with this to get the result that we wanted. Now, after I did this transform, I want to do something else. I want to make it, like I said, a little bit following this shape, because this one is thicker, this one is thinner, but I want them to be kind of following a little bit this slope to make it things interesting. So let's duplicate this nice node. And the way I'm gonna do this is by adding a mask grave texture. Yep, you can use mask grave texture to do this kind of stuff. So mask grave texture, and I want a combine XYZ because I don't want to affect all the axes. I'm gonna plug it into the offset, keeping the original position and adding to it. And I'm gonna use only one axis, this one that goes up and down. So let's plug this one here and see what happens. Let's decrease this value kind of like a lot. Something like this. Let me make it rounder. And now we, as you can see, we get this nice, very nice transform without much effort. And also we get some variation on it. So it's great. It's really, really great. So we did the alignment and we did everything that we needed for the dividers. Basically, the divider is ready to rumble. So now it's time to add the digits to our setup. So let's move to point three, adding digits. And this is a very interesting part, because if you just want to add numerals, it's easy. You have 12 instances, 12 numbers, more or less. But we want to add Roman letters. So that means that if we add a circle with 12 points and instance something on it, some instances will be made of 3 instances, some instances from 2, some instances from 1. And it, building a mask for this, I tried, it gets too complicated and makes no sense. So the way we are going to do this, it's create a little node group that will contain the setup to do the numeral and turn it into an instance. So if we, even if we have more instances, the outside will see only one. So then we can easily distribute those around the circle like we did with these parts here. So that's going to be the setup for this. So let me do this for you. We will start by adding a text, string to curve, and plug it here just so to have a reference. Excellent. And then I want to do something for this one. I want, let's say, add the numeral 1 And then I want to turn this into a mesh because I would just want the profile. I don't want a full circle. So let's do curve to mesh. Plug this one here. Add a circle to do the profile. And this circle, of course, is going to be too big. So let's do it. You don't need so many points. Let's do it like way smaller, something like this. And once we did this, I want to align things nicely to the center here. Baseline is okay. Center, because I want the center of the letter to be on the point. So the instances will not go like this or like this, to be exactly on the center when they are instanced. So things are nice. Now we have one object here, one instance. But if we put like two numerals here, then we get two instances and things get trickier. So the way to fix this is to turn this entire setup into a single instance. And for that, I'm going to use a mesh line, cancel the location, put the number of points to one, then do an instance on points. These are the points, these are the instances. And now we can plug this one here. So now we have this awesome setup that turns everything into one instance. Even if we have like whatever here, we have four here, but on the output we'll just have one. So that's nice. And then we have to turn this into a group. So let's select everything, do a Control G, and that's turning it into a group. And then this group, I want to output the string. I may want to change the size. I may want to change the character and word spacing. And also I might want to change the resolution of this entire thing. And of course the radius to decide how fixed the letter are. And that gives us this nice group. And the simplest way to do this is to simply multiply stuff. So I'm gonna do this now. Okay, so I duplicated all these digits and connected here. And now it's time to see how we can do what we needed. Like I said, we kind of need a circle. So let's add a curve primitive, curve circle. And we need this one to have like 12 points. And let me mute this one and connect this one here. Okay, so we need 12 points for this one. As a size, we kind of want it to fit here. So let's do 0.5. Let's see how things will look. We can adjust this. And these points will be used as instances. So let's do that. And this will be our instances. Awesome. But we need to do some things with this stuff. First of all, the scale is way too big. So let's do it like something like this. Then we need to fix the rotation. So let's do utilities, align Euler to vector, plug this one to do rotation. And we are going to use again the curve tangent. It's a very handy node. So let's plug this one here. And now things seems to be aligned correctly, sort of, but we have this problem. Everything is instanced on top of each other. So the fix is very simple. You have to pick instance, and now they will just do this. As you can see, choose one instance. But we have a few problems here. First of all, the alignment is not the one that we wanted. It's kind of look reversed, I would say. So let's see how we can fix this. Let's add a geometry. This is the simplest fix. And play with the rotation. On the, yeah, on the X scale, rotate it by 180 degrees. And then, as you can see, things are going the other way around. So we have to rotate them again on this axis and choose the pivot, different pivot. Let's see. Yeah, things are not right. I kind of pushed this where it's not supposed to go. I want to rotate the circle, not the instances. So now if I play with these values, now things are rotated correctly and I can decide where we start. And we want to start at the number 12. So something like this, 60. And something is still not right. Okay, so I did a little bit of debugging and it turned out that I plugged this wrong. So you must make sure to plug them in the right order from 12, 1, 2, 3, and so on and so forth. And after I did that, align Euler to X on the pivot Z. Otherwise, the last one is going to get ugly if you leave it on auto. And this controls the placement here, the Z axis, so 90 degrees. It's going to put the 12 here. And this controls this rotation because otherwise the letters are reversed. So rotate them on the X and then you can align them nicely by playing with this value here. So that's going to give you the final result that you see here. So time to move to point four, adding the cogs and the back plate. That's going to be also a lot of fun. So let me see. These cogs, they are very interesting because we are going to sculpt them in geometry nodes. So let's see. I'm going to start with a cube. So let me do this here. And I'm gonna take this node and plug it here. Okay. And now we will add the cogs. So let's start with a cube. Plug this one here. And we will do something on it. I want, let me temporarily hide everything else. I'm going to play with one of the new nodes in the geometry nodes, edge vertices, and I'm going to show you what I mean. Let's do first a set position. I'm going to plug this set position here, and I'm going to decrease like the Z height. I'm going to move it up like this. And then I'm going to build a mask based on the edge vertices. So let's do edge vertices, and I'm going to use also the index, because this is giving me an index. And we will build a mask using compare node. So let's plug this first vertex from the here. As you can see from here, this gives us the first vertex of every edge. And I'm gonna plug this one here, switch this one to equal to get that epsilon value, and then plug this one here and check out what's happening when we start to play with this epsilon value. Now we get this nice shape, and that's what I wanted from this this node. And I want to make things look nicer, so let me add a mesh subdivide after this operation, because I only want to play with very few vertices for this thing that we are doing here, and subdivide it a little bit to get a nice shape, something like this. You don't have to go too crazy, because this is just a tooth from our setup, so you are not gonna get too much stuff here. So let's duplicate this teeth. I'm gonna do a frame for this, shift D, steal this frame from here and plug it here. And now I want to do an instancing of this on a circle. So let's move this point somewhere here, and I'm gonna add this to this frame, and let's add a circle, curve circle, and this will be the points, and this will be our instance. So let's connect this one here and do the instancing thing here. Awesome. I want only, let's say, 8 teeth. So let's do this as an 8. And of course, this is going to be too big, so I'm gonna do it like a lot smaller. And of course, the instances are not exactly what we want. Let's make those smaller as well, and we start to see something here. We want to align the rotation, so let's do align Euler to vector, plug this one to rotation, and we will use again the curved tangent that we kind of used before. So let's use this curved tangent, and now things are aligned, but I want them to be moved the other way around. That if I want them to be reversed, so that will be, yeah, playing with this. Now we get this nice thing going on here, and I think I'm gonna also squash them a little bit, something like this. That gives us the teeth, and then I want this to be combined with something else. So let's do a geometry, join geometry, plug this node here, and let's build the inner ring of this this thing. So let's take another curved circle, and let's do more vertices on it and make it like smaller, something like this. And then we will do a curve to mesh, plug this one here, this is our curve. And then I'm gonna use a quadrilateral on a rectangle, plug it here, and plug this one here. Yes, everything is huge. So let's make this one like, say, 0.10, and then decrease this one as well, something like this to touch the teeth. And the height, I think I want a little bit more, I think, something like this. Yes, excellent. And this is looking too mushy, so we need a resample curve to add a little bit more resolution to this profile. So let's plug this one here and say like 32 points, something like this. And that's gonna give us the basics. So now we have like a cog here. So then we can use this cog to do a little bit of instancing. So let me bring on the other geometry. Now this one is kind of huge. So I'm gonna do something like this. I'm gonna do an instance on points, and we will need something to instance. And because this is circular, well, let's use a circle for this. We can use a mesh circle. Where are you here? I'm gonna switch to N-gon to have a face, and this will be the points on which we will instance stuff. But first we have to generate the points. So go to points, distribute points on faces. And then we will use this cog as an instance. And then we can plug this one here and see what we get. We get this. Okay. Awesome. Yeah, not really. Not yet. We get this humongous thing going on. And we have to control it. Let's do a little bit of variation on the scale. So let's do utilities random value. Plug this one here for the scale. And let's say let's make this one like very small. 0.05 to, let's say, maybe 0.2. Something like this. And then we can play with this density here. I want to switch to Poisson so we can make sure that we don't get intersection. And then I can increase this value like too much. Let's do something like this. Awesome. And now I want to build a mask for this. So we will build a mask to plug here into the selection here. And I'm gonna use for that a texture, a noise texture. And let's move this on a little bit here. Now let's do a math compare, plug this factor here, and greater than is just fine. And plug this one into the selection. And now we'll play with this value a little bit. Something like this. And we can play with the scale as well to get different patterns to your liking to look clocky. Yeah, I don't know if that's a word, clocky. And that's looking nice, but I want to do something else. I want to do a rotation to make those move. So let's do that quickly. I'm gonna do a value and do a hashtag on this one, hashtag frame. And then of course we will need something to control the speed. So let's do a divide node, plug this one here, and the speed, we can use it. But first let's do a vector combine XYZ, plug this one to Z, plug this one here, control H to hide that one. And now we have a controller for this speed here to make things move faster or slower. But I want those to go kind of in a random fashion. So let's do a random value here from, let's say, 10 to 40 or something, and plug it here. So now some wheels will spin faster and some of them will spin slower. And that will be how you can do this. So let's do a frame for this one. And then we can just do more of this. This is what I did. So let's do something like this. Let's do Shift D for this one, and then Shift D again, and plug this one somewhere here. Let's move this one even more, this one here. I don't need this joint geometry here. And but this one I can control Z. This one I can actually use to combine everything here. So let's do something like this. Then add the next level and then add the third level. Something like this. Awesome. Now we can add this one to our instances here, and then we can add this one as well to instances here. So now we have three levels that look exactly the same. So let's do some variation on this. Level two. I'm gonna play with the mask a little bit to change the pattern. And I also want to do something else here. For this one, I want to do a transform to push it down. So let's do the transform here and bring it down a little bit, something like this. So they are not on the same level, they are on different levels. Excellent. So now that we did this, we can add a little bit of variation. Okay, let me add some materials for this so we can basically see them nicer. So set material, plug this one here, and let's do like Cog 1 material. I already have it. Shift D, Cog 2 material, Shift D for this one, Cog 3 material. And now we can switch to material preview and we get a little bit of info on what we're doing, having different colors. So let me play with these values for the second level. Density, maybe increase it a little bit or leave it just as is. And then I want to play with the scale of these instances. So let's make those bigger, something like this and something like this. And then we can use this one at the end to also rotate stuff around, and we can play with the mask as well to change the values here. If we go here to this mask, something like this, and we can play with this, and then we can rotate it to get different patterns, something like this. And then we can do kind of the same thing here. Let's do a transform node, geometry, transform, plug it here and push this one down. Something like this. Yeah, but push it down, not rotate it. Something like this. Now we can see a third level. And for this third level, let's see. Let's play with the seed for this to get something different. And then we can play again with the mask here to get something different. And the scale as well. And we can also take it from the top and we can like rotate it if we want, something like this. And of course we can play with the values here to make everything bigger So let's start with this one from 0.3 and end up like 0.45, 450, something like this. And what else? I think we can play a little bit with the density by increasing the distance between these ones, something like this. Let's see. If I mute these two, we can see what we are doing here. So let's do something like this. Looks nice. And we also can change the animation for this one. So let's change the speeds. Let's do something from 15 to 50, maybe. And I also want to change the direction of these ones to make them go another way. So let's do a multiply here. And some of them should change direction, some of them should not. So let's do -1 to 1 on this random node. And some of them will be multiplied by 1. That means the speed will remain the same. Some of them will be multiplied by -1. So they will start to rotate the other way around. And of course, plug the frame here. And as you can see, some of them are rotating one way, some of them are rotating the other way. So that looks nice. Let me do something for these ones. Also, let me play with the factor to get a nicer pattern. Also decrease this till we get something nice, something like this. And I think I want to do the same thing here. So Control C, Control V, take these nodes, plug them here, and of course plug the frame here. And now we can see the same thing happening here. Awesome. So now we can activate all the levels of this and we get this nice free stacked level of cogs. And now we can activate the other stuff here and see how things are going. We need to play a little bit with the scale of this circle on which everything is instanced. So let me move this one up. And we have this original instance and everything here is instance on a circle. This one here. And we can actually do the following. We can use the same circle to control everything. So let me plug this one here. Do I want to do this? Actually, I like the variation, so I'm not gonna do this. I'm gonna leave things alone as they are. So let me plug this one back. So we have this variation, but at the end of this, after we did all three of them, I'm gonna add another transform node, plug it here, and scale everything down until I get what I want here, something like this. Even more, I think. Yeah. Now it's looking a lot better. So this is one easy way to fix this. And we can also now play with this node and decide where we want things. We want to leave room for the handles, for the clock hands. So we can push these ones down. And we can also play with the digits that we have here. So let's add a transform for this one. geometry, transform, plug this one here, and we can also push these ones down to have room for the glass and everything that will come later on. And also we can add transforms and move things around for these ones if needed, like aligning things nicely here. But I'm not gonna put this one here. You can see in the cleanup version of the file. I'm just gonna add the back plate for this watch because we don't want to see through it and see the brick of walls, brick walls. So this one is gonna be a simple one. So let's do a mesh circle. And let's plug this one here and switch it to N-gon to have a face. And of course we will not need a transform for it to decide the size. We can decide from here, but we will want to decide the alignment for this one, so push it down something like this, I think. And now we have a bottom for this, and we can see that we have to put the cogs up a little bit. They went down too much, just like this, and that's gonna be everything we need for this project. I'm gonna switch now to the finished view, so you can look at the cleanup tree and do screenshots for it. So this will be the cleanup version of the node tree. Let me make it full screen so you can see it. This is the our text dividers that we created. And then we have the Roman digits. If we switch to this node, this is what we find inside. And after these Roman digits, we have the setup for the cogs. We created the tooth, then the inner ring. We multiplied the tooth by instancing on a circle and created the cog. Then we instance that cog here. We created a mask to break up the distribution, and we created a little bit of animation. And then we did two more versions of it, as we can see here. This is the third version. We added the materials and some transform for alignment on top. And of course, this is the inner dial with which we started. Again, a circle. We did a bit of sculpting on it with a simple mask. The outer dial, same thing, different result. And then in the end, we have the back plate that is covering everything. And everything gets connected. Everything gets a material. And it's shade smooth. And that's the result that you get from this with the materials. Remember, if you want to see how the materials were made, check out in the description the link for the video for that making of the materials. Thank you very much for watching this video. Remember, if you want the project, you can download it from Gumroad, only €2, and you can get this cool project and support this channel. Thank you again for watching. Have a nice day and happy blending.